If you're watching this channel, you're probably into technology. You might even be thinking about a career in technology. Well, today we have a special guest, Tina Williams, a woman of technology who wants to share some of her sage career advice, starting with skills.
So in the area of skills, I think what you can evaluate is whether you want to go deep or broad. So what I mean by deep is that you may decide to enter technology and you have a specific love of a specific area, and you want to become the subject matter expert there and devote your career. And I've seen a lot of women do that successfully and rise up and become distinguished engineers and submit many patents. It's a really great way to have your career. For me, I started out as a developer. I was coding in assembler in PL1 long, long time ago. And I got to the point where I wanted more and I wanted to experience new things. So I wanted to be more involved with clients. I moved over into consulting. I then moved over into business development and then on into marketing and eventually found my way back to software. And now I am a product manager. So I've taken all of those experiences along the way to apply now to being a product manager.
Oh, that's a great way of starting deep and then using that as a springboard into new sort of areas of technology. That brings us to the next one, which is called leave. What's that up with that?
Well, it's not really about leaving. It's okay. About thinking about when you get in, if you're going to be moving from different area to different area, thinking about your end game. So I always think about
the next job is what you're saying, right?
Right. So working my way out of my current position into what I'm going to do next, you know, leaving open the door for me to go do something else. And that's really gets back to my desire to be creative and innovative. That's really where I'm drawn to and starting new, you know, initiatives or transformations. And so once I have that all in place and I have everything operational, it's time to move on to something else. So that's one way you can approach your career, is to think about that as you're going into a new job. I also think it makes you less controlling and more collaborative also, because you're thinking about handing it over.
In fact, I would argue that, at least in my career, I've always said every 2 to 3 years, you want to be thinking about moving on to a new role, a new responsibility. If anything, just to keep you being a more well-rounded employee with more education, more knowledge that you can share. But that brings us then to messy.
So messy, that's really to me about getting your hands dirty. So as I moved around from different job to different job, there was always a new type of technology that I was working with. And so in order to become comfortable and confident in that area, I first took the time to really understand the technology. And so for instance, I was a product manager within IBM. I was helping to roll out a new CMS system across all of our global organizations. And so first, before enabling all of those different teams, I took the time to really understand it myself and actually be able to use the platform myself. And now today I'm involved in an area of AI. And so I'm taking the time now to really understand that platform, get my hands dirty, understand how it works. And therefore I'm much more confident when I talk to my colleagues and clients.
Also, you're a lot more authentic because you have experience with it, not just from reading, but doing.
Right.
That's great. So elevator, that's a rather obscure title. What's that about?
So it ties in with the rest, whereas if you want to move around in your career, mm-hmm. you're not likely to do that without getting to know people. So a great way to get to know people is to talk to them in the elevator, which isn't intuitive or always considered normal or proper. But for me, I've met lots of people in the elevator at all different levels, my peer colleagues, and then also executives. And I find that people are very willing to talk about themselves and what area they're in. And I've learned so much about different areas to explore that I would have never found out about otherwise.
In fact, that's how Tina and I met, is she was walking by the studio. We got to talking about career and I said, why don't you come on and tell us more about it. So I'm really glad that you did reach out like that. Well, you get the final word with the category of more.
So this is something I just think about for all women and really for a lot of professionals, is that it's always good to ask for more. Like, always ask for what you want. Always ask about new areas. Always ask for more money if that's what you think you deserve. Always ask for new opportunities. If you don't ask, then no one knows. No one knows that you care. And they may just it's not that they don't respect or appreciate you, but they may not prioritize you.
It reminds me of something one of my mentors actually said is that you are your own best advocate, so you need to be one. Well, you get the final word, offering advice to the ladies out there who are thinking about technology. What would you say to them?
I would just say technology has been a great career for me. I've had opportunities to learn, which is something I really enjoy. I've had opportunities to fly all over the world and meet all kinds of wonderful people through technology. And it's just been a great career.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much, Tina. Hey, before you guys leave, be sure to hit like and subscribe. And also, if you'd like to see some other topics, leave us comments below.
Thank you. Thanks for watching. Before you leave, please remember to hit like and subscribe.